And as I said before, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Makanaqua High School. Tonight we have the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings and the Makanaqua Braves. Vikings are coming into this game 3-1. Makanaqua coming in at 0-4. Valley coming in after that heartbreaking loss to Warsaw, 66-42. And they'll be working to bounce back from that one. And Valley will start off with the ball, and Sophie Buzzard gets an easy two. That took about 3 seconds there. And Valley already on the board. And Buzzard will take it again. Broyette now up. Didn't get the basket, but she will go to the line. First one is good. Boyette will go 2-2 at the line. And we'll be called for the foul there. Valley playing that aggressive defense that they've shown all season. I don't think McConaughey's ever been on the other side of the court tonight. And there they get there. But they give the ball up. Miller on the inside. Can't get that. That one will go out of bounds. Still Makanaqua ball. Oh, and Ann Sechrist said no. And she's going to go up. And she'll get the two. Good rebound there by Dunn. Addie Miller on the inside. And Valley's already up with a 8-0 lead here. Shot no good. Hannah Dunn lost it out of bounds there. Still Valley ball. Miller again on the inside. She'll get that one to go. And Sechrist call for the foul, her second of the night. Shot no good. Rebounded, and Broyette will come up with it. Sechrist inside. Couldn't get it, but Dunn will go to the line. Takes an unlucky bounce. Second one is good. Emily Peterson is now in for Valley. Valley with an 11-0 lead. Peterson called for the foul. Hannah Dunn gonna go. Oh, can't get it. Rebounded by Buzzard. She can't get it. But Buzzard's gonna take that one. Still can't get it. Emily Peterson now can't get that one. You gotta be able to make those. Shot no good, still in bounds. Oh, that one's gonna go off of Sophie Buzzard.
Give it up. There you go.
McConaughey still has a zero on the board as that one sails out of bounds. Boyette open on the outside, gets it in. Boyette with the rebound. Boyette thought about the three again, decided not to. Peterson will take it. A little over for the mark. Asia O'Connor and Kylie Sloan will come in for Valley. Call, and that one will go to Valley. Valley seems to have shaken off that lost to Warsaw. Boyette on the inside. Doesn't get that one. Kylie Sloan set to inbound. Dunn on the inside. Not able to get that. Three-point attempt, no good. Peterson. Sloan again, set to inbound. Done again on the inside. Tried to throw it in backwards, but Asia O'Connor puts it in. McConaughey is still yet to get on the board. Good there by Asia O'Connor to sling it over to Peterson, and she'll get the two. And another takeaway there. Kylie Sloan gonna go up now. Doesn't get it, but she will go to the line. First one is good. Olivia Trapedi now in for Valley. Sloan can't get the second one. Valley gonna try to shut out the Braves here in the first quarter. Loses the ball. Kylie Sloan gonna go down. Can't get it. You gotta be able to make those easy layups. Asia O'Connor call for the foul, her first. Kate White at the line for McConaughey. And that'll be McConaughey's first point of the night. White will try to make it two. And she does. So McConaughey finally now on the board. Peterson for the two. No good. O'Connor with a good rebound, and that one will roll right in. Shot is good. Jolie Gardner made the shot. Kylie Sloan can't get that one before the buzzer. And at the one, Tippecanoe Valley is up 21-4. Maddie Miller and Asia O'Connor lead Valley with 4 points apiece. And good first quarter there by Valley. Definitely shaking off that heartbreaking loss. This is the first conference game for Valley. McConaughey is 0-3 in conference play.
To the Lady Braves basketball program. For each free throw scored, Chris Allison, All-State intern, will donate $5 to the Lady Braves basketball.
No, we're recording. How would you need them?
No, my sister was just asking if you guys were broadcasting. I'm just going to pick it up.
Not live.
Okay.
And both teams getting ready to start the second quarter. McConaughey will start with the ball here. Loses the ball. Kylie Sloan gets it. Buzzard on the inside, and she'll get the two. That'll give Buzzard 4 on the night. Olivia Tripedi can't get it. Asia O'Connor still no. Kylie Sloan no. Good effort there to keep it in bounds by Buzzard. Foul will be on Kylie Sloan, her first of the night. Jolie Gardner at the line from McConaughey. First one is good. Gardner will go 2-2.
Taking out the lineup for the Lady Braves, number 12, Samantha Powell.
Hey, back here!
Tripedi open. Can't get the long two. Good rebound there by Sloan. Buzzard almost loses it, but puts it in and up. Now we'll give Buzzard 6 points on the night. And another turnover there as Valley will come up with the ball. Meredith Boyette will come back in for Valley. Bad pass there by O'Connor. Kate White will go to the line. Kyla Sloan call for her second foul. White makes the first one. Addie Miller will come in for Valley now. She'll go 2-2. And Tripedi will be called for the travel there.
Here we go, girls!
another turnover there.
Watch out, right there.
Chipedi looking for Broyette. Addie Miller is open for the three, and she didn't get it. And it looks like another turnover. I think McConaughey's giving Valley the ball. Morton are giving it to themselves. Sophie buzzard up. No. Still Valley ball. Buzzard loses the ball. And Seacrest will come back in for Valley. Sophie Buzzard. That'll give her 8 points on the night. Buzzard had 7 points in that loss to Warsaw. 3-point attempt, no good. Valley will come up with it. Broyette on the inside, can't get the bank. And McConaughey loses it again. Seacrest up. Gets it in. And McConaughey calls a timeout. Valley leading here 29-8. And against that loss to Warsaw, Ann Seacrest led the team with 14 points. Followed by Addie Miller with 10. Again, that was a heartbreaking loss, but right now, Valley doesn't seem to be affected by that at all. They're just playing regular Valley basketball. As of right now, Sophie Buzzard is leading Valley with 8 points. Maddie Miller and Asia O'Connor and Ann Seacrest both have 4 apiece. And Tanisha Brown will now be coming in for Valley. Number Coach 20, Kendig likes to utilize the depth that he has on this team. He's used everybody on the bench except for number 40, Mackenzie Woodcox. And Woodcox is a JV player looking to prove herself on the varsity court here in the potential later parts of this game. And bad pass there. And another turnover. Turnovers are killing McConaughey right now. Addie Miller for three. Can't get that one. It'll go over the backboard. Take over there. I had to go to the Braves, actually. McConaughey just can't seem to keep a hold of the ball. Two-point attempt, no good. Sechrist down in the paint. Doesn't get it, but she'll go to the line. Sechrist looking to extend Valley's lead here. Makes the first one. Second one, no good. Doesn't make that one. Shot no good, just short. Sechrist inside, and that's just easy for her. Hard fall there. I believe she hit her head on the court. That might leave a goose egg.
We have a 30-second timeout called by Valley.
And Valley will take a timeout. Sophie Buzzard still leading Bella with 8 points, and Sechrist following behind with seven.
Here we go, Roy!
Yet open in the perimeter. Couldn't get it. Sechrist with a good rebound. Trapedi will go up and in. That'll be Trapedi's first points of the night. And the ball will go to Valley. Sechrist inside, gets it to go. That'll give her 9 points as she'll take the lead for the most for Valley. Shot in and out. Trapedi gives it to Broyette. That one will go in.
That's it, by the way.
Valley leading this one by 30. Jolie Gardner at the line. And she got that one. Olivia Trapedi was called for the foul. Second one just off the front iron. And Valley will most likely hold for one last shot here. Boriette for three. Over the mark. And they're not able to get it before the buzzer. And at halftime, your score is Tippecanoe Valley 38, Makanaquan 9. And we'll be right back after halftime. And welcome back here. Valley leading this one 38-9. And if I'm Coach Kendig, I'm telling my girls, hey, just keep doing what you're doing, because it is working out just fine. If you're Makanaquah, You gotta stop and see Christ on the inside. She is a big threat there. And you gotta also be careful of Meredith Boyette and Natty Miller on the outside. Very few teams have been able to stop that combination. As we get set to start the second half here, Makanaquah will start with the ball. Seacrest took a fall there. Stepped out of bounds, I believe, yep. That'll be Makanaquah ball still. And the shot no good, not enough oomph in that throw there. And oh, bro, yeah, just lost that one. Bad pass there. Still Makanaquah ball. Valley with their aggressive defense, and she gets that one to go. Kate White from Makanaquah. Boyette thought about it. Decided not to take it off the knees of Seacrest there. Maddie Miller for the long two. She'll get that. Stole. Seacrest on the inside, and As I said, McConaughey's got a stopper if they want a chance of coming back here. Hannah Dunn, call for her first foul. See, Chris will take that one. Buzzer, good job staying in bounds, and that one will roll in for Hannah Dunn. And shit. Maddie Miller at the line for Valley. And that one is good. Hannah Dunn on the inside, no good. Bad pass there. Still McConaughey ball. Buzzer takes that one, and she's got a free lane. Oh, she couldn't make it. Addie Miller will get that one.
Basket by Miller.
That'll give Miller 9 points on the night. Asia O'Connor and Emily Peterson coming in for Valley. And that one will be taken by the Vikings. Have a jump ball. We'll go to the Vikings. Peterson for three. Got it. Sechrist inside. Can't get it.
Grab the ball, lady. Two hands.
Timeout, McConaughey. And Sechrist is leading Valley with 11 points. Addie Miller has 9. Valley with a commanding lead here. Ah.
number 4, Hayden Michael, for the Lady Braves.
Peterson sets inbound. Seacrest for a 2, no good. Peterson with a rebound. Seacrest inside, and she'll get that one.
Hey, Lexi! Lexi!
Kylie Sloan will come back in for Valley.
Number 12, Kylie Sloan.
Peterson will take that one. Boyette inside, and she'll get the 2. That one will go out of bounds off the hands of Boyette. Three-point attempt is no good off the front iron. Seacrest slings it to Broyette. Broyette will bank it in. Olivia Trapedi and Hannah Dunn will come in now. Kylie Sloan will pick up her 3rd foul. 3-point attempt, that one is good. Kate White for McConaughey. Peterson will attempt one of her own, and that's no good. Trapedi gonna take it back. Kylie Sloan inside, and she'll get that one in. Almost lost that one. Braves will hold on to the ball. Olivia Trapedi call for her 2nd foul. Kylie Sloan called for her 4th foul, and she'll need to be careful here. Coach Kendick might be looking to take her out so as to not get fouled out of the game. Still McConaughey possession. Braves still able to hold on to the ball.
That's all right, that's all right.
Done inside. And that one will not count. Peterson set to inbound. And Dunn will try again. Can't get it. And that one will go off the fingertips of Kylie Sloan. And that one will go into the hands of Olivia Chipiti. Chipiti, that'll be a two. Can't get that. Kate White inside, no good. Peterson open for three. Oh, not able to get it. The ref keeps that one inbounds, and it's going to go to Valley. Hannah Dunn inside. Not able to go before the buzzer. And at the end of three, Valley is leading 60-16. And Valley's just about met their scoring average for four quarters, as Valley's scoring average is 66 points a game. Seacrest has 13 points for Valley. Meredith Boyette with 11. And Addie Miller with 9. Tanisha Brown will be back in for Valley, as well as Asia O'Connor. That one, McConaughey with some very bad ball handling skills in this one. Dunn inside, can't get it. That one no good. Tanisha Brown will come with it. Brown will try and she'll get it.
Keep driving, Kate, keep driving.
Actually, they're not going to count that one. That one off the hands of Tanisha Brown. Chipiti gets that. Oh, yeah. Peterson open beyond the arc again, and that one will go for.
3 point bucket for Peterson.
That'll be the second time she's made it from beyond the arc. Ball will go to Valley. Or excuse me, McConaughey. 3-point attempt. No good, but she'll go to the line. Hannah Dunn called for her second foul. Gardner makes the first one. Gardner no good on the second. Again, she will get three shots since the foul was called on a 3-point play. Third one no good. Hannah Dunn running down. Brown inside, and she'll get that. That one will go out of bounds. And that one will go straight to Tanisha Brown. But she will be called for the travel. Bad mistake there. Addie Miller coming in for Valley.
Taking back into the lineup at number 22, Addie Miller.
Coach Kendick has used everyone on the bench except number 40, Mackenzie Woodcock, says that one goes in for number 20, Kate White. Hannah Dunn inside, banks that one in.
That's it for Dunn.
Hannah Dunn signed on to play at Anderson University to continue her basketball career. As she'll get the rebound there. Brown inside, can't get that one, but she gets her own rebound. Can't get the second chance point. Asia O'Connor, still no. Still Valley ball. Great rebounding there. And mishandled there by O'Connor. Shot no good. Tanisha Brown on the call for the foul.
Here we go, Kate!
Her first of the night. Kate White at the line for the Braves. No good. Should come up with the ball, though. Still no good off the front iron. she'll take it again, trying to get something here. That's a two-point play, I believe. No good. And O'Connor will come up with it. And Coach Kendick doesn't seem to be happy with the effort there. Well, the timeout. Valley leading this one 67-19. Valley's next game will be their own home tournament, as they will play in the first game at 10 a.m. against Fort Wayne Wayne, as on November 26th. And from there, they'll either play Fort Wayne South or Appleton North from Wisconsin. I don't know many teams that would want to travel that far just to play a basketball game, but our athletic director, Dwayne Burkhart, being able to get them to come over. Just under 3:40 to go here. Done inside, no good. Trapedi slipped up there a little. Hannah Dunn inside. Valley playing aggressive defense. Hannah Dunn comes up with it thanks to Tanisha Brown. Trapedi inside. That one will go in. Valley now has 71 points here, as McConaughey shooting themselves in the foot with bad ball handling skills. Tanisha Brown inside, no good. She'll try it again and get that one. And this one is far out of reach from McConaughey. That one no good there. And Valley will take a timeout.
Oh, yeah.
And Mackenzie Woodcox will now see the court. And Coach Kendig has used everybody on the bench. And that's what you like to see. They like to get the girls all the experience they can get, especially the younger ones. Woodcox took a fall there. Able to get it to Miller, though, and tried to keep it in bounds, but not able to. Cox will score there. She's only a freshman. Not a two-pointer to make that. And just hold for one last shot here, as Valley will take this one with a win, 75-23. And Valley will improve to 4-1 on the season, 1-0 in the conference. And that's the bottom line, because the scoreboard says so. I'm Chris Seacrest, and you've been watching a RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. Good night, folks.